All right, in this one I have a treat for you. It's knowledge that it's good to know, but it will never serve you ever. That's the best kind of knowledge. So today we're going to talk about digraph and trigraph and why they're removed in the C23 standard. So as you can see, I have a little example code which just creates an array, loops over the item, prints them, and then prints some expression that is from a ternary. Doesn't really matter. If I compile this and run it, it does exactly what you expect. Nothing fancy. And so yeah, that's it. But then there is a thing that's called digraph and trigraph that comes to ruin the day. And it's basically in the old days. From what I understand, some keyboard didn't supported some characters that were needed for the language, and so they created some combinations of characters that are equivalent to the characters that are used in the language. So, for example, if you type question mark equal, it is equivalent to the pound or the hashtag character. So here in this case, I could replace this hashtag by equal equal. Question mark equal, same thing here. And if I compile, it doesn't work, but that's because there is a compiler flag for it because it's very old. You need to specify trigraphs. And now, as you can see, it compiles flawlessly, and that's your code. Aren't you happy? And yeah, you can also do this for like the braces. For example, there is one, there is a open caret for the open brace, so you can replace this by this and this by closed caret. Same thing here, because why not? Might as well convert all our code base to use a trigraph. That sounds fun. And so yeah, it just works. There is another one for weights. Oh, there is another one for the square brace. Let's use that as well. Why not? I already forgot what it is. It's parentheses. If you want parentheses instead of square braces, you can always use this, so like so, and here might as well, oops, like so, and damn, this is so readable. I love it. I think I'm gonna write all my code like this. No, not gonna lie. And yeah, that's about it. There is one for the pipe. There is one for the tilde, and one for the backslash, which is quite tricky because it can create a, like here. There is a comment that says. Like that is frustrated a bit, then there is a slash, and then all of a sudden you end up with a backslash in your code, which is kind of funny. So yeah, that's basically trigraph. And so at some point they realize, I don't know, I have no clue when this was introduced, but at some point they realize, oh, this is not very readable, guys. So you know what? I have a great idea. Let's replace that by other weird combination of characters. And so they created a digraph, which is basically a similar thing, but with two characters instead of the three characters question mark thing. And so yeah, it's extremely readable as well. So yeah, let's use that instead. I think that will make it better. So for this, I can use open caret and percentage, and for this, I can use this way. Indeed, it's much better. I feel feels clean already. And for this, I can use this, which actually looks cool. Well, I mean, it's fucking confusing, but it looks cool. So, and this can be replaced by this. And I mean, you get the gist of it, but I'm gonna finish it just so that you can appreciate the beauty of it. Like so. Ah, God, this is awesome. I love it so much. And so if you do this, see, it's the same behavior as before, except you have a better code, basically. Oh yeah, there is one for the hashtag. Wait, let me improve my code quickly. Yeah, that's it. Ah, that's awesome. And so yeah, I think that's about it. I think C++ does its own thing as well, where it has like a name alias, but that's lame. We prefer like the weird character combination, I think. And so yeah, that's about it. There is also, I think, like for the question mark thing, there is at some point Like there is, you can have also three question mark, and then the three question marks are considered as one question mark if you have a minus after it. So you see, it's very intuitive. So if you have a ternary like this, and then you can have like a three question mark and then a minus, and then this will be end up being just a regular question mark as well. So yeah, that's, oh wait, no, it will end up being a minus or something. Anyway, this is confusing. Anyway, that ends up being, I know, a question mark, but then also with a minus, but then if you don't include the minus, it's a compile error. Anyway, I'm heavily confused, but that's awesome, and that's why we love C. And yeah, I hope you, you definitely learned something. I hope it wasn't useful, because if you use that, you're a monster. And yeah, see you in the next one.